Hey, good morning. It's me, Melissa. And today our devotional is on first loves. First loves. In Revelation chapter 2, verse 5, it says, "Remember, therefore, from whence thou art fallen, and repent and do your first works, or else I will come to thee quickly and will remove thy candlestick out of its place unless you repent." I want to talk to you a minute first about first love. You know, we've all got a first love we had somewhere. And if you remember, you couldn't wait to be with them. You wanted to just spend time with them. And when you weren't with them, you were thinking about them. And you'd get so excited thinking, oh, I'm going to see him Friday. And there you'd be. There is such a passion that goes on in first love. It's almost hard to describe unless you've been there. Well, when we walk with the Lord, this is what he's talking about. There is a real danger. As we get stronger in the Lord and more sophisticated, and we learn more, and we've got more knowledge, we've increased in knowledge, but and we're probably a little more polished. Well, when that happens, a lot of times that fire and that zeal is gone. It's slipping away. I know how easy that is to happen because we get overwhelmed, especially in ministry. You get overwhelmed with scheduling and routines, and we got to do this and we got to do that. And everything is timed in ministry. It just is. And so I don't know a single mature Christian that has not battled this at some time or another. And if you ask a lot of people, they'd say, well, yeah, I still love Jesus. I love Jesus. But do you love him with the fire and the passion that you had at the very beginning of your relationship? And for most people, if they're honest, they'd have to say, well, things have cooled a little bit. Well, a good example of first love is found in the church of Ephesus. Ephesus was one of the largest churches in and renowned in the in Asia, in Turkey, actually. And it was founded by Paul in the first century. And these believers had come to Christ with such fire, like a blaze of glory. And at the onset, there were demonstrations, incredible demonstrations of healings and deliverances, people being raised from the dead. They saw all of that. And there were people, they even burnt their occult books. They didn't want to be associated with the demonic realm anymore. And they were so sincere in their service to the Lord. And in early years, that church at Ephesus burned like a spiritual inferno. And they had such a vibrancy and excited. You know, here's the deal. I've heard people say, I can't wait to get to church on Sunday. And then after a few years, they say, I can't wait to get out of church on Sunday. You know, I'll be glad when it's over. I've sat through this stuff long enough. Something happens to that fire in us and that passion in us. And so as the church grew and the knowledge increased and they got smarter in things and took on a whole lot of new roles that they didn't really need to take on, Jesus kind of just began to diminish in their lives. And they still had their habits and their customs and their traditions, but that became the most important thing. You know what I'm talking about? I know you do. In Revelation 2:4, it tells us that they had lost their first love, their first love. In other words, they lost that simplicity and that passion that they had for Jesus at the very beginning. God's urging them, stop right where you are and think about what's happening in your life. Think about what's happening. Go back to the beginning and start over again. The word remember is from a word, it's meneia, but the first part of the word, or the main part in this, is that it's a record that's to memorialize somebody's actions. It could be a monument, a statue, a sepulcher, but something that would make you begin to think about that person. And it's it's kind of like this church at Ephesus. It was a sepulcher after a while. And 30 years of activity, they just buried it. And they threw dirt, the dirt of schedules and routines and all this, on the grave. And it just got worse and worse and worse. And then the word remember also, like I say, it referred to a statue or a monument. And this tells us that there are some things in your life that need to be a monument, that stand taller. Our relationship with Jesus is one of them. I remember telling somebody a while back, I want to tell you about what happened when I got saved and how wonderful it was and the feelings I had. And the more I went back and thought about that, I thought, oh my gosh, that was the best time of my life, the very best time. I was so excited. I couldn't wait to get to the church. I couldn't wait to be in His presence. And then life set in. Anybody want to give me an amen on that? Because we need one. Here's the thing. You know, most statues are made of metal and stone, and they endure for years without human effort, but our memories are not like that. They have to be deliberately maintained and cultivated. I want to go on just a little bit further here. It's not that activity is wrong and schedules are wrong. It's not. It's just that they become consuming and they take the energy from the congregation. I'll tell you, too many churches have ushered out the Spirit of God, and it's time we start ushering Him back in. The more I think about this, the more I think, you know what, God? We've pushed the Spirit out. We've lost our first love. We're not with Jesus with that passion and that fire. I want that back. I am willing to do whatever it takes to get so much fire in me. I think Sunday morning, if you were in church, you would have thought, okay, she's working on this really good. Because the fire of God fell in that place. That was the neatest service we've had in so long. Why did it happen? Because I am determined that I'm going to change the way I think, and the way these activities and things are going to have to be pushed to the side so that I can run back to my first love. What about you? What about you? Remember means to be continually mindful. And he says, you've fallen. That word fallen means you have fallen from a high and lofty position. But it actually means you've already fallen. That's what he was telling him. You've already fallen. Now we need to do something about this. This beautiful church had a wonderful past. And now that's what it is. It's their past. What about you and Jesus? Let's just get real here. What about you and Jesus? Are you so excited to be in His presence you can't wait to get up in the morning and talk to Him? Are you excited when you go to church and think, man, I can't wait to see God show up in this place today? I just can't wait. Are you there? Or are you in that place that says, you know, I've got to do this and I've got to do that. I hope I haven't got time. We're missing Him. Our first love, we're missing Him. I beg of you today, think about this. Father, for every time that I've pushed you to the back, I am so sorry. And Lord, I know there's so many out here. So many of us have fallen into that trap, Lord. Help us not to stay there, but to realize we've got a first love that we got to run back to with every fiber of our being. Father, we love you. We love you, but Lord, we want to put you first. I want you back as our first love, my first love. Thank you so much, Jesus. In your precious name, amen. Amen. God bless. Give this some thought. Amen.